Welcome back, model friends and fiends. We know what time it is. We didn't do one of these in April because I was so busy building, and May is going to be just as busy, if not busier. But on this weekend, this Saturday's video, we're going to start taking a look at new kits and products that have come into the workshop, personal stash, manufacturers have sent things over. Let's take a look at new sponsors, brand new groups that have decided to send things to the channel so you guys can find out what is in stock, what's going to be in stock. It's all different kind of things. As always, I'm going to continue building plastic models twice a week and trying to throw in bonus videos of tools and outdoor equipment and pressure washers and any kind of cool stuff that we see come in. First up is a combo of both. This is from a company called Mad, M-A-D, and they don't seem pretty angry. They seem pretty happy. They sent over their 1/10 scale working model engine. It actually goes into RC models. We're going to be able to build this one up. You can see it's got parts on parts trees like any other plastic model would, but then it's got a working gearbox, a block. We've got colored valve covers. We got all kinds of cool stuff in there. And these things are like 25 bucks for this really awesome looking modern V8 engine. So you can see that in there. So that's going to be fun to put together in a quick little bonus video. I wanted to let you know that the latest issue of Model Cars magazine is available. Issue 213, you can pick it up from modelroundup.com, throw it in with your next model car order, and they will get it to you. They did a nice article on me in issue 212, and Model Roundup has those in stock as well. And this is an excellent magazine since Scale Auto is now defunct and out of business, and Fine Scale Modeler is a joke as far as car models go. We've got a new product from a new sponsor called QCS, Quick, Clean, Safe, a product of Stripwell. They sent me a gallon, I've got three more of these, to test out their Model Safe paint stripper. I use Super Clean a lot. The problem with Super Clean is, though, it is very caustic. It's bad on your skin. My hands just rip open and crack. You need to use gloves all the time. It is vapor harmful, so you got to be careful how you use it. This is supposed to be non-hazardous, eco-friendly, non-vapor harmful. You're supposed to be able to use it and not have a problem. So we're going to test it out stripping different kinds of paint. I'm going to test Tamiya, tester sprays, Rust-Oleums, primers, all that. We're going to see how this stuff works and whether you should be using it on your models. From Tomlov is this... They offered this because I've done these microscopes before on the channel. And this thing is huge. 10.1 inch LCD screen, massive magnification, it records images. We've got two little lights on this giant stand base. We got the remote control. I think this would be great for us older farts and newer guys, not only to explore the world we live in, because microscopes are cool. I mean, they're fun. Also, for modeling, you can put your figure kits here, your detail kits, your small wires, your lines, at the bottom of the screen and look at it up here as you work instead of looking through the lens of a microscope or using reading glasses, which unfortunately at the age of 44, I've had to start to use just a little bit, but not a lot. This should alleviate a lot of that and you don't have to keep switching lights out and everything. It's rechargeable, it stands on its own. It's got two lights on there and a remote control, so that's pretty cool. We're gonna open that up and take a look at it. And then, remember the Chevy square body from FMS radio control models that I did and rusted out and beat up and put a camper on it from Hobby Burger? Well, they saw the video and they loved it. They said, we've got so many of these cool things coming out. Would you put them on the channel? I said, hell yes, because come on. RC is fun. Scale models combined with it. So they sent over three of their most current kits. This thing is awesome. A four-wheel drive. Look at the farm tires on that thing. All right. Four-wheel drive, fully articulated. They call it a Mogrick. I call it a Unimog-looking vehicle. Got the upper air intake. Got little lights on top. I don't think the lights work on that. The headlights work, but I don't think the upper lights work. We'll find out. This thing is much too cool. Got a cargo bed. We got to find stuff to put in there. 1/18 scale. That's going to be fun to crack open and take a look at. They also sent, I didn't even know this thing was a real vehicle. The military modelers will love this one. Weathering and beating up, it's a 1/12 scale Volkswagen Type 82E. It's a bug, but it's four-wheel drive. It was used by the Germans. It's got all these cool features inside. You can see the full engine and transmission, opening doors, opening hood. It's got an engine in it. We're gonna be able to oil this thing up, dirt it up, crust it up, and take some cool pictures outside. So they sent that one for a look-see. And they sent the one that I really, really wanted because I like little Toyota trucks. They sent the 1/18 scale Hilux, the 83, four-wheel drive. Interesting because it looks like it has the exact same wheel and tire package as the Chevy, but then it's got the Toyota with the full gray interior. The tailgate opens. The guys over at hobbyburger.com are going to be making some 3D accessories for this that they're going to send over, and when those arrive, I'm going to be putting those in here and seeing how we can weather it up and beat it up and drive it around outside. I'm going to reset for the next set of sponsors, and I'll be right back. Next up from these three awesome sponsors, we are back with an A&N Model Trucks 124th kit. We've unboxed these before. We're going to do a full unboxing of this beauty. Their Dodge 3500 dually pickup truck. Look at that thing. Check it out. I can't wait to see what's inside this box. They are in Latvia. They get stuff shipped to us all the time. I think they, as far as I can tell, as far as I've looked at personally, A&N Model Trucks makes the absolute finest resin model kits I have ever seen in the automotive genre. I wish they'd get into some figure kits because these guys could really blow the figure kit out of the market. These things are amazingly detailed. If you haven't seen my reviews of their kits before, go and check those videos out. We're going to be unboxing this beauty on the channel soon. We've got from Model Rectifier Corporation, yikes, 1/16 scale Panzer Kampfwagen 3 Aus Tank. This thing is massive. Over 1,500 pieces. This is a 3-in-1. We got the Type L, the Type J, and the Type N. Steel or aluminum gun barrel in the box. It's got photo etch, metal gun barrel, build your own tracks, copper tow cables, massive set of decals. This kit, I mean, look at the size of the box. You can tell this thing is monstrous. So we're going to be opening this up, letting you see everything that's inside of it so you know what you're buying. Model Rectifier Corporation has these in stock right now. ModelRectifier.com is where you can pick this up. And we will be opening that up and showing it as a nice bonus video. I like to do those. And the folks at Fanhome are still sending product, but I like to do two shipments at a time. And this is the last one I've gotten in the past 2 months. There are supply chain issues. They sent out emails to all the subscribers that things are slowing down a little bit, but we're going to keep getting them. And when I get the other box, we'll start building. But this box right here had steps 31 through 34. You've seen me build it up to that point. I'm not really sure what's all in this one, but we've got some, oh, we got exhaust. Definitely can tell that's exhaust. We've got more exhaust. And wow, this looks like a floor pan or a trunk pan, big hunk of steel, whatever it is. So the Fanhome stuff is continuing. We're going to keep building it. We're going to keep working on it. We just have to wait till all the steps catch up. And I like to do 8 steps per video at a time. So I'm not doing a 2-second video. I can do a nice 30, 35 minute video that you can kick back, listen to some music and watch. So Fanhome is continuing. We're gonna be doing some other unboxings. I'll be back with the next sponsor. We're not even close to done to showing the kits. You got to see the pile that's behind me over here that I have to keep setting up. We got so much cool stuff. One thing, wonderful news, just excellent news to hear. ICM is back in production. They are literally having war outside the factory while they're producing model kits. That's dedication to the hobby and their business. So they were able to get some kits out, and they're producing more kits every month. They're getting the Ghost of Kiev and everything. So we've got some cool stuff to look at. First up, in 1/72nd scale, for you guys that love the 1/72nd scale, I enjoy it for quick, easy builds, is their Type G4 Partisan Wagon with Machine Gun 34, MG34. It is part number 72473. These are getting into the hobby right now. They're just reaching the markets. We'll get the glare off that box there. And you can see that beautiful box art. So those you can get from your local hobbyist. Check this out. This is really cool. In 1/35th scale, for the 35th scale figure builders, American Civil War Union Infantry set number 2. It is kit number 35023. That looks lovely and has the figures that you see on the box ready to go. These kits should be arriving in the United States if they haven't already. I know a lot of manufacturers and a lot of dealers have these already on the shelves. This is their G7117 U.S. military truck. Deuce and a half, like vehicle, 1/35th scale for all the military folks. You can build it one of four ways. You can see all the lovely ways you can build that sexy machine up. It is kit 35597 from ICM in the Ukraine, producing models in the middle of a war zone. Don't think that's ever been done before. And then we've got the, and I'm going to butcher the name because I love doing it, the 10.5 centimeter LEFH 16SF Auf Geschützwagen FCM 36F. Whew, wow. That is, why do they got to put so many names? German is hard enough, and I'm half German. All right, this is a World War II German self-propelled howitzer. That's much easier to say. It's in 1/35th scale. It's got a really cool design to it. Camo this thing up, build it anyway. It's a 3-in-1. So you've got the decals and the options to build it in one of those three versions. That is kit number 35340. Pick that one up, you armor fiends, and you will enjoy it. From our folks at Model Roundup, they've sent over stuff. These Kyle Larson kits from Salvinos JR, you saw me build up the Chase Elliott kit. It is the same kit underneath with the HendrixCars.com Kyle Larson sponsorship livery in it. These are just getting to the market. You can get this on pre-order at ModelRoundup.com because these are going to sell very, very quickly. And you want to make sure you get these when they come in. They're 1/24th scale. Check out my unboxing and build of the Chase Elliott kit. These things are amazing, and they don't require a drop of paint to make a really hot looking stock car. You can of course go ahead, paint and detail them to perfection, but out of the box, these things build up just as they are. So getting folks into the new NASCAR is quite easy now with those kits, so get that on pre-order. This one you don't need to get on pre-order because it's in stock right now. Model Roundup has in stock the Technicar 20-foot container trailer from Italy. It is in 1/24th scale. This is definitely getting a full build on the channel because I loved building the 40-foot container and beating the hell out of it, and that's what I'm going to do with this one. I can't wait to scratch some decals off and get some rust and some dings and dents from the shipping containers that we've been waiting for 2 years that are never coming in through customs. So that's why I thought this would be a fun one. Look at that huge decal sheet in the box. That's what's going to be in there for us to decorate that model with. And this thing is, that's got to be like 3 pounds, I think. That's a heavy kit. So a lot of stuff in there. It is kit number 3887. When you go to ModelRoundup.com, you can get this right now. And you can get that Kyle Larson car on pre-order. I'm going to reset for the next sponsor and be right back. In the past 2 months, the personal stash has grown. It doesn't mean I'm going to be building these kits, but I also like to collect kits. I mean, I build 104 kits at least per year, two every week, and usually an extra couple throughout the year. So I like to also collect kits, too, that I think are unique and original, and maybe someday I'll get to. From Miniart, 1/35th scale, the Werkstattenkraftwagen, so in other words, a work truck, type 0330. So this is really awesome from Miniart, kit number 35359. Comes with everything you see on the box, all right? So we've got the tank, We've got the air compressor. We've got the ladder. We've got all the crap on the roof, all the tools, and this cool Werkstattkraft wagon. You can see it. I mean, it shows it all on there. All that stuff is in the box, so that's pretty awesome. And Miniart's out of Ukraine, so we're glad that they are producing kits again. Mobius released their Wonder Woman 1/8 scale figure. I don't know if I'm going to get a chance to do her up, but well, not that way, but, you know, build the kit. So that is pretty awesome. That is finally available, and people have been waiting for this. I've been hearing about this coming out for like 2 years, and finally, it is on shelf. So, and that's a styrene kit, not resin. That is plastic glue together type stuff. From Italeri, I saw this. It is an F-104G cockpit. It's in 1/12 scale. It's got all the decals and everything to make this huge aircraft cockpit. It's going to look pretty cool when I retire and get a chance to build it with all that instrumentation in there and all the decals and fine painting. That looks like a lot of fun. I've seen these built up, and I was able to get it at a good sale price. I always watch all the model places for great sale prices and stuff like that, and grab stuff when I can. From Aoshima, I got the Honda Dream 50 motorcycle bike. I haven't built a lot of motorcycles on the channel. I'm hoping to. I actually have a Honda on the way from Japan, supposed to be here in June at some time. And when that real Honda arrives, we sure as hell are doing a review on it, because I'm pretty excited to get it, but I'm not going to tell you what it is until it actually gets here. So we got that kit coming in. I've been in a Honda bike dream mode for a while. We've got the Honda Monkey from Fujimi. This is the original Monkey style. You can tell by the magnesium wheel, or you can tell by the gray cast metal wheels and the drum brake in the front. They make a new Monkey, which is a really cool motorcycle, but this is the old Monkey style. Tamiya makes a model of the new Monkey, if you're interested in picking that one up. From a company called Gecko Models, I've never bought a kit from them before. They have produced a 1/35th scale skid steer. It is an armored style skid steer for the US military, but there is you could remove the armor and stuff like that and make it a civilian skid steer quite easily. So I picked that one up just because I thought it was super cool. I was at an antique store the other day, and this wooden model kit was sitting on a shelf for $2. The same amount that Ricky owed on his newspaper subscription, $2. So, and I had the $2 on me because I didn't pay the newspaper boy. If you get that reference, you get extra bonus points. I picked up this Conestoga Wagon wood model kit. They make all, I've collected a bunch of these. I have the covered wagon. I have the stagecoach. I don't have the chuck wagon. I have the horses. So I had to get the Conestoga. For only $2, they sell for a heck of a lot more on the E of the Bay. I also picked up from Tamiya, I love Tamiya kits and I like Toyota vehicles, Toyota Supra from Tamiya, sweet model car kit. Maybe someday we'll get to that, maybe not, but I definitely wanted to collect it since I don't own it. And this thing popped up. Who says Facebook doesn't know what you like? This weird ass looking Celica Supra, the Long Beach Grand Prix Marshall car. It's got the blue and yellow lights on the top. Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach. Got those nice Toyota Heritage stripes on the side. This thing looked way too cool not to buy it. It was only like $30, so I had to get that kit. And a guy I know bought this kit quite a while ago. And it's a 1/16th scale MPC 1979 Pontiac Firebird. If you're interested in this kit, ModelRoundup.com does have it in stock. I checked before I made the video. But if you're interested in this kit, it's huge. I mean, and it doesn't have, it's got a lot of parts, but that's just because they're big. Now, you've seen me build other 16th scale models. This thing's got opening doors, opening T-tops. Well, a guy I know bought this and asked me if I'd buy it off of him. He didn't want it anymore. It never cracked the plastic, nothing. And I got it for a song. I got it for less than you'd ever see it on a 40% off sale or anything. So I'm going to be probably building this up. It is a 79 Firebird. I do like the Firebirds. It is a cool kit. It's got steerable wheels, opening doors, and it looks like it builds just as nice as the other AMT 1/16 scale kits with the opening doors and stuff like that. So I'm looking forward. It's got a solid body shell like I like, but then the doors open, the frame. It's got the unibody kind of with the frame there. So this one I will probably, from the personal chance, try to get on the show. We'll see. There is also another giant Firebird coming out from Revell. You're going to hear it here. I found out from a viewer who sent me a message that Revell is going to try to issue the 1/8 scale Firebird, the 79 1/8 scale. That thing is like 2 feet long. I'm really pumped about that. I'm trying to pull some connections to get a hold of one from a sponsor so we can get it on the show so I can build that big sumbitch and get it on the screen. So we might have to do two this year. I might do one in this yummy gold or a copper with the fire chicken on the hood. And then the 2 foot one, I can already tell you, if the 8 scale one shows up in the United States, I'm going to build that one as a bandit. I have to. It's big. I just have to. I haven't built a bandit kit yet, so that's what I want to do. I will set up for the next sponsor, and we'll be right back. Second to last on this video is a wonderful channel sponsor. A lot of fun stuff comes out of Atlantis. Not only will you car guys be happy coming up, because all this stuff you see on here is in stock right now at Atlantis and at modelroundup.com. They've got the stuff except for these models here. The car models I'll show you are in stock at modelroundup.com. So let's take a look at all the cool stuff coming out from Atlantis that you can pick up right now. The JN4D Curtis Jenny. It is in 1/48 scale, so the aircraft guys, it's called 1/4 scale because 1 inch or 1 inch equals a foot, I think, and or 1/4 inch equals a foot. I get excited when I'm making these videos. I screw up all the time. 1/4 inch equals a foot, 1/48 scale, beautiful yellow biplane. This one I really want to build because I don't build a lot of airplanes, and I definitely don't build a lot of biplanes on the channel. And it looks like a simple kit. It's got a total of how many parts? 62 parts, so it should be quite easy to assemble. The Curtis Jenny is in stock at this moment. Also in stock is this huge set, 12 Combat Task Force Fleet ships. It's got them all in 1/1200th scale. You can see the size of the hand next to it. It comes with an ocean base on the back in that 1200th scale. How many parts are in this kit? 140 to make 12 warships. Everything you see on the box except for that dude's hand is in there. Aircraft carriers, battleships, cruisers, submarines, tenders, supply, all in there. And it gives the names all the way across the front. So when you see it, they got the battleship Washington, the Canberra, the Galveston, the Dewey, the destroyer, the Sullivans, the Sullivan brothers. Yes, so classic kit out from Atlantis. And this thing, I just asked for it because I thought it was so cool. This probably be a bonus video. It shouldn't take long at all to do. The amazing Amoeba kits are out. Sort of like the Visible Man kits. Now the Amoeba. Old style kits molded in clear plastic. Got a back reference there. Look at this. They've got a stand like the two lower ones and the upper one. How many parts are in there? 13 parts. How can we not build a kit with only 13 parts for a fun little bonus video? The Amoeba is in stock and will actually teach you something while you build. Now you car guys will be super duper duper excited. Atlantis does not forget the car people. They help you guys out quite a bit. I know when they first got the molds, everyone said, "Oh, it's going to make old airplanes." All you negative Nancys are always wrong, and now you are. Yellow Fever Competition Coupe from Keeler's Customs. This is a new kit. The new kit. Atlantis isn't just doing reissues, they're doing improvements and new kits. Let's see, 100 plus parts it says. Awesome decal sheet in there. Two complete engines. This is available from Atlantis Models and from modelroundup.com right now. These are all in stock at both of them. Son of Troublemaker Dragster, a Tom Daniel design. We know how easy Tom Daniel kits go together. They build up into really nice kits. We got this one. This dragster where the back end opens up and the engine's in the back down there. It says the wheels turn and everything. Check that out. How many parts are in this one? I love that they put it on the box. 71 parts. 71 parts in there. They do it like Revell does theirs where they list the parts and the size. We've got the 57 Chevy Bel Air hardtop. build its stock or drag. This kit is unique, and a lot of people wanted to see it come back out. It's got a total of 185 parts. Why? Because on this kit, the hood, the doors, and the trunk open. So this is in stock right now from Atlantis and ModelRoundup.com. And finally from Atlantis this month, the Jungle Jim Funny Car. Check that out. That is iconic. I mean, everyone knows that car. I love building these up because they build up easily and they make for awesome display models. Jungle Jim has 91 parts in the box, builds up to almost 8 inches long because it is a funny car, so it's longer than a usual car. That's going to be a fun buildup. And we thank Atlantis for all their support. They are a small company. They're making their kits in the USA for us model builders. They're coming out with new kits. They're reissuing the super old classics. You see how much I love building their vintage stuff, their nostalgic stuff. Now I'm going to set up for the final sponsor, certainly not the least sponsor. They've got a massive amount of kits that are going to be on this table, and we will be right back. And now, to make it through the giant pile of kits that has arrived since April from Round 2 Models. They're sending out all kinds of stuff. A lot of vehicles. Lots and lots and lots of vehicles. So you vehicle guys are going to be super happy. First up on the table, though, is the UFO from Area 51. This giant 1/48 scale kit is molded in clear for the upper and lower hulls, which gives you all kinds of options to model. The two alien and the one guard figure included, they give you painting tips. It's 13 inches across. It's a pretty cool sci-fi kit. So you guys that love to do the sci-fi stuff, when it coming in the clear plastic, that means you can mask it off to see inside the ship. You can light things. You've got the bridge. You've got the gravity amplifiers with interior detail and then everything in there. So you can work on a lot of cool stuff with that. And now the vehicle kits for you folks out there. Check out this behemoth. I built this kit as the Hostess model, and now they've released it with U.S. mail decals. It's got the Ford tractor. It's got the short single axle trailer in the back with working doors, a sliding door and everything. It is the same kit, the C900 tilt cab tractor and transmobile 27-foot van. 10 vinyl tires. It's the same kit as the Hostess truck. You can see that review, and maybe we'll get time, we'll put this one together. But otherwise, you can check out that Hostess review if you want to know everything that's going to be in this box, minus the awesome U.S. mail decal. So I hope to see more trucks with that U.S. mail. I'd like to see a straight truck, because that one I would build up. They want you to know that back in stock is the 40 Ford. I built this one up and had a really nice time on it. You can see this video. It's in Coke livery. I thoroughly enjoyed it, so check out that build video on the channel. Just search for 40 Ford Coupe or 1940 Ford. It will pull up for you, and you can grab yours now. The supply chain is working better now. Ram Charger's Funny Car, Legends of the Quarter Mile from Mpc, 1/25 scale. Check out that Challenger in the classic. We'll get the reflection off that again. In the classic Ram Charger's livery, and as always, they got all the cool stuff on the back, and this one comes with parachutes. Yes, you can set up a nice little diorama on there. Massive decal sheet. We got pad printed tires, so we're going to be having a nice looking dragster on that. This one arrived a while ago and I hadn't done a new kits video, so I didn't get a chance to show it. All the way from Round 2 Models via the AMT label, 3-in-1 build it stock, custom, or racing 64 hardtop, the Mercury Marauder Fastback. Tons of custom parts in that box. Pad printed tires. Oh yeah, it's a very heavy box. A lot of these this month are heavy, heavy. They got a ton of stuff in them. Mercury Marauder has to be built because I don't think I've ever done a Mercury on the channel. And this one, the 76 Cabrice. When I posted this on the Facebook channel or Facebook page, which you should check out, people were really excited about it. 3-in-1, build it as a stock 76 Chevy Caprice, a security vehicle, in other words, with security labels and decals, or as a hauler because it comes with a complete trailer. So you get the 76 Caprice in the box and a trailer. The trailer is pictured all the way on the back of the box, so it's actually in there. The barn in the country scene isn't in there, darn it, but the trailer is. Check out the back. You can see all the parts for the trailer in there. Got the deck, the trailer itself, and that big, huge Caprice body. 6 tires. We're going to be able to see what's all in there when we take that one, open it up, and build it. The Barris T-Buggy for you custom guys. I know these are popular with a very select crowd, but this thing is pretty sweet by George Barris. They've got that 60s Mpc box style on there. Build it pretty much any way you want with the stuff that's in the box. Detail it. It's in 1/25th scale. Look at all the cool stuff on the back there. And we got that big, big, big improved decal sheet as well. We're not even near the end of the pile from round 2 this month. The Copperhead rear engine dragster sitting in front of the engine. That's an awesome vehicle. 1/25th scale. Has an optional axle mounted spoiler, spoke wheels. Got the big honking Goodyear slicks on there. The one piece body, which makes working on this way, way easier. And then on the back, you can see the parts count is not very high. I love the one piece chassis. That makes assembly a lot easier. I think it was a one piece chassis going down to the nose there, which should make things a lot easier on us to put it together. And we should be getting this one built up on the channel as well. Wow. It's been a while since folks saw this one, and I know they're going to be happy that the Ala Impala, the 58 Chevy Impala, built in 1 of 3 ways, stock, custom, or competition. You can really go hog wild with this thing. Now, knowing me, I don't know. That looks so sweet in a blue on the side of the box. I like the stock. Maybe we fade it. Maybe we give it just a little bit of rust. Who knows? It's my model. I'm going to build it my way, just as you should. A lot of nice looks at the parts back there, and that is one big decal sheet. So there's a lot of options on there. It's got 6 tires in the box. We got some drag tires. We got stock tires. Let's see if it gives us anything more on the... Ooh, look at the custom in that green. Opening doors. Wow. A lot of the stuff on the box out there that they always restore and get working for us. I didn't even know this kit existed. In the Coke livery. All right, comes with 4 Coke bottle crates. The 1980 Dodge Ram D50. Yes, finally being reissued. I know you mini truck fans are going to enjoy that. You're going to have a nice time building that bad boy up. It's got the little 4 popper, got some seats you can customize, got some custom wheels, and got those really cool Coke crates in there so you can enjoy them. Painted in red, gives you a view of the decal sheet, and it does have the gauges and everything in there, so you can build a completely stock Dodge D50 just because the Coke emblem's on there. It just helps it sell it so they can fund building other kits and producing other kits. Doesn't mean you have to build it as a Coke vehicle. You can just buy the kit and build it up. It's got a lot of stock details in there. The Myers Manx is back out. Yes, 1/25th scale. We got the special release. Includes print suitable for framing. Original box art on there. Jumping that Manx. I think I built this as another version as a dragster before. Very similar. I love the little top on there. The optional Surrey top. Not a lot of stuff in the box. Should be a... Oh yeah, I've definitely built this before as the rail sand dragster. So we're going to see this again because I want to build the stock Myers Manx. Never had it on the channel. It's got the plastic tires and 6 vinyl tires, so don't worry. You're not going to have to worry about the plastic tires too much. You got the 6 vinyl tires in the box and a huge decal sheet. So we'll be building that bad boy. We'll get it opened up. The Batmobile is back from Batman Forever. The nipple Batman wore his suit, but there is no Batman figure with it. Nice box art on the side. Get that detailed up. If you want, you can give it that blue glow like it had in the movie. Aside from the original Batmobile, I think this would be the first Batmobile on the channel. The decal sheet, it's got gauges and equipment and all these bat symbols for the wheels, everything else. Full color back, gives you a painting and detail guides. You can do this in a couple shades of black, and it's injected in black as well to make it a lot easier to build that kit. Should be a very fast build when it's already injected in color. These two kits just showed up today from Ups, arrived at the shop, so I wanted to get them on the video. The 1962 Corvette 125th. This is another 3-in-1. 3-2-1 kits. You can build it as stock customer racing. On the front, it's got the vintage box art like that with the engine exposed. Total gasser with the moon tank in the nose. Nice stock-ish version on the other side. Got our super duper custom right there with the engine sitting with the blower to the side with a little like air ram in front of it. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Box feels heavy. All full of parts. All kinds of cool stuff in there. You ever seen the movie Collision Course with Jay Leno and Pat Morita in the beginning of the movie? That's what I'm thinking for this car. When I heard I was getting a 62 Vet, that's what I was thinking about. And this box, you hear that? It's so heavy. 2005 Cadillac Escalade EXT. I didn't even know this kit existed. From AMT, 125th scale. Looks like you can build it as a complete stock Escalade. I had no idea this kit had ever come out. It says it includes factory stock and custom wheels, over 125 parts. Well, that explains the weight. Holy cow. Tree, all this stuff in the back. It's got five wheels, so it must have a spare in there. So yeah, it's got a nice decal sheet. Looks like it's got some gauges in there, make the dashboard work easier. So yeah, that would be a very interesting build on the channel. Never did something like that before. Finally, a kit. You can see it's just the box top. I'm actually working on this kit right now because I've never built a PT-109 before. This is AMT's reissue. I'm pretty sure it was an old motorized Lindbergh kit back in the day of John F. Kennedy's PT-109 patrol boat. Has the decals. I love the box art on this one. Has some black and white pictures of JFK. Has history. The manual's pretty cool. It's got a nice set of stickers for the flags to make them easier to stick together and stay where they go. And then it's got decals to do more than just PT-109. So that's getting worked on right now. We've got a boatload, ha ha ha, of kits from AMT, MPC, Polar Lights, round two this month. Now the video is all done. Go out, start getting your pre-orders ready because I'm gonna start building all these kits and I'll see you at the next review.